Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.
I'm supposed to start off this show by laughing, but then, due to my beautiful new sponsors, that is Nana Habo, I've so far used the mouthwash. It's different. I honestly have to say, it felt good to use something that reminds me of my childhood, and it felt so good to use something on me in this day and age that reminds you that some things can be herbal, because everything is synthetic these days. So talking about my sponsors, I saw Yabadani, Bahati, Doni Bahati, Gaya Janakola Pati, Kampalanga, Inabualukumirukumi. And Katra the Punk, that one. And you walks at who? And you have a deco walks at. Ngavasinisa, Manya, Gaguba. Mana inana mtoke mbayambo yaba jeka mparanga yaba tugambi bako mamu December. But wali weko ku productism. Because I was seeing these grown men seated at a mall and trying to tell us their future plans for this December. I'm like, what? How old are these punks? Anyway, that's besides the point. I'll delve into them later. My name is Tina Fierce One. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop, and it's not any regular edition. It is the edition where my teeth are clean. Now, given my week officially starts on Tuesday, let's start it up. I saw a video clip on Rita Kagwa's Facebook page. It was of Spice Diana, Supaisi. I need to say it the way she says it. Supaisi Diana was on stage and she was getting rubber-dubbed by fans. Now, it wasn't just a regular rubber-dub, like the fan just jumps on stage, everything goes crazy, and then security has to throw him down. No! She literally called these men on stage, you know, give you a bit, feel the person that you are walking, that you came to see. And it's okay. I've seen very many different celebrities do that. I've seen actors, actresses, you name it. When you call out a fan and you're like, yo, come, have an experience with me. Now, though, what bothered me about Spice Diana's experience is how she was comfortable with all these weird-looking horny men fondling her on national stage.
Yeah, something like a national stage. Or a national bar. The national bars, whatever bar you go to, zimanyi kidwa.
Oh, praise. I'm just saying. I was watching this thing in disbelief, and I didn't want to like pounce on it and give Spice Diana like a lashing or whatever with my tongue, because it's up to her and her management. But I'm just asking, morally, she called the first guy on stage. He dabbed. He was all over. He took off a jacket, and she was cool. Then second dude comes on stage, and this is the part that confused me. She goes, peeks inside her top, because clearly she probably didn't have a bra on, and laughs, and then lets the guy, she's like, okay, touch. And then the guy just grabbed her boob like, zoop. And then she goes like, oh my God, stop. I was like, the industry of China, one in our agenda. No, I can't fault her. I do not know what she wants in life as an artist. I do not. But I have seen even the lowest come not let anybody at that particular moment, because you do not know how creepy people are going to be at that moment. What if he was just a creepy guy and instead of touching the boob, he would have just like yanked off the top? There was nothing much holding it. Like, at times. But it's Spice Diana, why do we care? I never say anything nice about Salvador. No, at times I do, but the thing about, I think it's a hate and love relationship. I always have to pepper it up or salt it up or sweeten it up. Like, I can never just go one direction with Salvador. But for the first time in history, I'm going to go down and say, you know what, Salvador, for the first time, I honestly saw a lot of maturity. I saw a lot of growth. And I saw someone who honestly wanted what he wanted. And that's a little bit of good stuff, you know, to go along the way. Because he was saying that when he supports Bobby Wine for the, what's it called? The Tax Must Go, it doesn't make him a Bobby Wine fanatic. If he supports Bebe Cool and goes for his concert, it doesn't make him a Team Bebe Cool fanatic. If he supports Chameleon and, you know, chills with him and stuff, it doesn't make him a Team Chameleon person. He just says it makes me a person who understands and respects these three people because they pretty much changed the Ugandan musical scene. And he's a musical lover. I was reading that post and I was like, you know what? You go, Salvador, you go, you do that. You let everybody know. Because it's confusing why everybody wants to be put in a particular bucket. Like, oh no, I'm Team this and this, I'm Team this and this. There are people out here who really don't care about what team you're on. We are the type of people who will tell you Chameleon released a new song. We're the type of people who will tell you, well, Bobby Wine is doing us proud, but well, he's about to be Bobby Wine. The type of people who are going to tell you, well, it's Bebe Cool, he's a fool, but hey, he's been part of us for all these years. Like at times, why do we always have the urge? Why do we always want to badly be put in one basket with what, a particular type of people? I mean, stereotyping is not always the thing, but I was so proud of Salvador when he made that statement. I really was. It showed some maturity. But then again, it kind of showed how fake Salvador can be. Because when you give such a statement, it means no one is going to hold you accountable for all your actions in the future. So if you're going to be chilling with Bobby Wine on a Monday and you're chilling with Bebe on the second day and then Camille on the next day, I mean, no one is going to hold you accountable. If you ask me, that's actually a very smart move. It's a very, very, very smart move for you, Salvador. And, you know, do you. I was proud. I'm asking, Vanange Nina Rose, what is your claim to fame? Apart from looking like a Ugandan Amber Rose, which she does quite perfectly well, if you ask me. Her hair is tinted to the right color. I doubt if it's still her hair, because tinted ya kutule MV. Yeah, Mani. But Mani, why is she relevant? What do I want to make now, Manyambu? If I cannot sing and I failed to make my mark now, I should branch out into other things. I think Nina Rose should be the type who is gracing magazine covers because she has a good body for it. Look at you, what you wear, Sibaku industry, Takwa Angala, get something. Actually, Nina Rose, Nanda Kwagera ne bossy wange kat. Auntie, no, I have a new boss. Nana, have a mouse wash. We could put you on our billboard. She could be the face because she's gorgeous, but whenever you're kuyimba, honey, you can't sing. You sound pathetic. You sound so bad. You're like, and I thought it is easier for me to mute and then watch the video. But every time I'm watching the video, I remember how bad she sounds and I just turn off the entire situation. Don't go, man. MC Kapale and I hear Mariach, MC Mariach. First of all, I feel like they have watered down the MC title. I feel like it has been watered down. Y'all don't even understand what a true MC is. But I'm not going to give you a lesson. I do not want to. Like, for me, I was just pissed off. Like, every 2 weeks, MC Kapale is always hollering and hollering at a different, you know, comedian. And if he's not on social media, he's probably on TV or radio, and he's always calling out someone. But in my mind, I've met Kapale. Me and Kapale are good. We vibe. I don't think after this episode we'll vibe though, but we vibe. He's cool people. He's a funny guy when he wants to be funny. But Kapale, this is what I have to say. This whole nonsense of always trying to grasp—you're always grasping for someone to take down with you. Mariach has done this. Salvador takes our jokes. I cannot believe they have killed the industry. We are I helped him. Then he used me. I'm like, what, dude? You always have the perfect example for why you're actually not a hit. You're your own problem. Your excuses. The excuses you keep giving. And what has let you down? Sawa bino ina go yombe sambu atwala jokes afinazi imbe Nigeria cheap here. Cheap here. Who doesn't know that Salvador does that? Is it news? Then you have to learn how to keep your best jokes to yourself because you know if you put them out there, he's going to use them. See cheap here. Mate Mariach has done this. I helped him and then he used me and he started backstabbing. Oli nakachi. I was watching you sometime on Facebook Live. He was on Facebook Live and he was just complaining. Munyambe, Mukorechi, Twitter got sent. The whole thing comes down to management. And that is what is killing this entire industry. That is what is going to make us forever stay this backward. Imagine our Tanzania by Natero Twitter. Do you know what that means? I love my Tanzanians, but if they agree, honestly speaking. You need management. And most of you are so ill-mannered, very egotistical, big-headed, that nobody can manage you. Then when it all fails because of those three, you begin pulling at different straws and, you know, crying foul. Honestly speaking, Kapale, everybody honestly, I've had anyone who has worked with Kapale, there's always a complaint. If it's not on Kapale, on Kapale's side, it is on the other person's side. On the back of international, oh sorry. Yalita genza international, wagamba ya sulem. Yagenda international, na yakoma mkayumba kembwa. I'm just saying, Kapale, I got you some love. I do love you, but I'm tired. You're like those old, petty, annoying, short women. Who blame? I didn't get Chiku actually. Chiku buku. There goes my Tuesday. I'll catch you again tomorrow. At TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And do not forget to buy yourself some Nana mouthwash. Yes. And as, especially, by the way, there is a comedian. They told me I wunya akamwa. Yeah? Enough of the fooling around. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop was sponsored by
Get Nana Habbo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.